For centuries, rats have been used in various ways to torment prisoners and enemies. But not all methods were equally terrifying. Throughout history, people have come up with cruel and creative ways to hurt each other. There seems to be no end to the scary tools designed for torture, but perhaps one of the scariest methods doesn't involve any complicated machines, just rats. Rats often trigger fear and disgust in many of us. These creatures can chew through almost anything, including human flesh, making them horrifying tools for torture, especially when someone knows how to use them effectively. For ages, diverse techniques of rat torture have echoed across the globe. From the corridors of ancient Rome and medieval London to the landscapes of 20th century South America, brace yourself for the unsettling history behind one of the most bone-chilling methods of torture known to humanity. The precise origins of rat torture remain a mystery veiled in the corridors of time, but its chilling inception can be traced back to at least 60 CE, within the formidable domain of the Roman Empire. Notably, historical accounts from the Torture Museum recount Emperor Nero's unnerving utilization of these rodents as tools of justice against his adversaries. Across distant lands, India holds its own grim chapter in the narrative of rat-inflicted torment. It is told that hapless prisoners awaiting their fate were ensnared in loose pants, cinched tight around their ankles. Within this cruel embrace, rats were unleashed, their desperate struggle for escape translating into harrowing scratches and bites upon the prisoners' legs and groins. Continuing our journey, let's step into the heart of medieval London. Imagine the formidable Tower of London, a place that carries the weight of history. As described in the pictorial history of England, this tower held a sinister secret, a dungeon dedicated solely to rat torture. Imagine this eerie chamber tucked beneath the waterline of the River Thames, a pitch-black abyss that awaited its unfortunate occupants during the receding tides. Now picture the tide gradually rising, bringing with it an unsettling horde of rats. In the darkness, prisoners lie helpless, their senses alert to the eerie symphony of scurrying feet and the unsettling sensation of creatures crawling across their bodies on the cold, unforgiving floor. It's almost eerie to consider the claim by Catholic partisans that these voracious creatures would even tear at prisoners' flesh as they slept, adding another layer of dread to this horrifying narrative. In these early stages of rat torture, simplicity was the hallmark, and fear often surpassed the physical suffering for many victims. But as time progressed, imagine these methods taking on more sinister forms, crafting a haunting legacy that solidified rat torture as one of history's most chilling and gruesome paths to a nightmarish end. Picture a grim period in the 16th and 17th centuries known as the Dutch Revolt. It was during this chilling time that one of the most sinister forms of rat torture emerged. Imagine a malevolent method where rats were trapped within a cage without a bottom, set upon a victim's vulnerable abdomen. Above this cage, a small tray held burning coals, their heat intensifying the torment. Now follow the distressing sequence. Envision the rats, driven to desperation by the searing heat, their instincts guiding them. With no respite from the heat, they turn to the only soft surface available, the victim's flesh. Their sharp claws and gnashing teeth punctured through, a harrowing journey into the victim's bowels, inflicting excruciating suffering and unrelenting terror. As recounted by short history, this nightmarish technique found its early usage in 16th century Europe during the Dutch Revolt. Diederik Sonoy, a Dutch leader, became infamous for employing this method against captured prisoners. Visualize the unfolding scene. As caged rats were placed upon prisoners' abdomens, sheer terror gripped the captives. The imminent threat of the rats' advance coerced many terrified men into revealing any information they possessed, often before the searing coals even entered the picture. Word of its effectiveness spread, transcending borders. Unhinged leaders worldwide recognized the potent combination of rat torture for both interrogation and punishment. This chilling technique took root and extended far beyond its origins. Remarkably, it persisted well into the 20th century, finding dark applications in certain South American countries. As revealed by the Harvard Crimson, the chilling era of the 1970s saw the rise of Chilean dictator Augusto Pinochet. A harrowing tale emerges. Pinochet's political opponents became victims of rat torture. Reports detail how his military forced live rats into the bodies of female prisoners, an unimaginable horror that sends shivers down the spine. Imagine the heart-wrenching account of a woman. "I endured violation, assaults by trained dogs, and the torment of live rats." In parallel, Argentina's military junta held power during the notorious Dirty War. Within this dark epoch, a sinister innovation unfolded. Soldiers, devoid of humanity, utilized telescopic tubes to guide rats into prisoners' bodies through their rectums or vaginas. The depths of cruelty seemed to know no bounds. Notably, documented instances of rat torture are rare. The very idea of coercing a rat to consume its way through a person's body appears so ghastly that even the most sadistic tormentors hesitated to wield it. From the scant pages of history, one truth emerges with unsettling clarity. Rat torture remains one of history's most nightmarish forms of interrogation. A stain of darkness upon humanity, its legacy serves as a chilling reminder of the depths we must strive never to reach.